thanks to our leaders, Mr. Child, teachers, all of us. Thank you very much. And thanks to all the program participants. Thank you very much, especially Chanel. So thanks to all of you and everyone who had a part in the history of the program on tonight. It's very important to know your history, and God wants us to know our history. God did not want the Jews to look back and wonder how they got over it. And so he gave them the Passover to remind them of the deliverance from bondage in Egypt and the crossing of the Red Sea. And when Joshua led the people later on across the Jordan River, he set up at Gilgal some stones of remembrance so that they could go and look at those stones and not wonder, but how did we get over? How did we cross the Red Sea? God wanted them to know. God wants us to know our history and it was the relationship, even slavery, their relationship with Lord Jesus Christ that carried them through. Many of those songs, many of those biblical scriptures, they grew out of experiences. In fact, a few years ago, Pastor Hopgood, when he introduced the hymn, he would give the history behind the hymn. It is Well With My Soul, for example. If you don't know the history, Google it and look at the history behind that. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. There's a history behind that song. It grew out of something that the person was going through. Through it all, Andre Crouch lost his father, his mother, and a brother, and was diagnosed with several different types of cancer. And it was in the midst of all of that he wrote the song, Through It All, Through It All. So all of the songs that bless us today, there's a history behind them. They grew out of something. The writer didn't just sit down and say, these are some beautiful words I'm going to put them together. No, they were going through something. And so thank you very, very much. I always love these history programs, and I get somewhat upset sometimes when I think about how I went through school and didn't know any of this, didn't have any of this information taught. And so it's really as an adult who I found now about many of the inventions and things of that you have. But thank God, as Pastor Hopkins said, we've come a long way, but we have a long way to go. And thanks to all of those who are paving the way. Now I'm going to give a brief prayer and then I'll give the benediction. And my favorite benediction, I have a number of them that I give, but one that I love more than any other is called the Aaronic Blessing. It's also called the Priestly Blessing. And in Numbers chapter 6, God said to Moses and Aaron, I'm going to bless the people, but these are the words that you're to use. I'm going to do the blessings. But these are the words to you. And those words were in Hebrew. And so I'll give it in Hebrew and in English. And that's why I give it in Hebrew. It was given in Hebrew. And in Leviticus chapter 6, Aaron was not able to touch all the people when he gave the blessing. Of course, in the Old Testament, with blessings, when fathers blessed their children, they would put their hands on them. Jacob with his grandsons. And in the last chapter in Luke, Jesus, when he blessed his disciples, he raised his hands, which was a symbol of touching them, to impart the blessing. And in Leviticus chapter 6, Aaron raised his hand to bless the people. God did the blessing. God gave him the words that he was to use. So benedictions are very important. Don't leave the church before you hear the benediction. That's a part, very, very important part of the service. A blessing is being asked for you. And so I will raise my hands, which is a symbol that I'm touching you, and pronounce the blessing, but it's God who blesses. I'm just an instrument. So please keep that in mind. That's awesome. And Lord God, we thank you for our time together tonight. We thank you for all of our program participants. We thank you for parents, relatives, and friends who return to be supportive of our children. We thank you for Sister Childs and her leadership and all of those who work very closely with her. And so we give you thanks. And we just pray now your blessings upon us that we leave this place. Is anyone here who does not have a personal relationship with you through the Lord Jesus Christ? I just pray that you would open their eyes and that you would draw them to yourself. And we ask that you would take us home safely now. Grant us the grace today to walk in the steps that you have ordered for us. Yeva rekekam Adonai v'yish medekam. Ya Adonai panam elekam v'yikrimekam. Yisa Adonai Panal Eleka Beyasin Eleka Shalom. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. God bless you and have a good evening.